So I have my r is inversely proportional of my small r, okay? And in this case, my theta varies from pi by 2 to minus pi by 2. The clockwise semicircle of infinite radius we have to draw, and number of infinite semicircle depends on the type of system. Like for my transfer function gs, hs is equal to 1 upon s into s plus 1 into s plus 1 by 2. For this type of system, I got a Nyquist plot. My polar plot for this is like this, and its mirror image is like this, and my final Nyquist clockwise encirclement is this, and my Nyquist plot is this. Because there here is a type 1 system or only one pole at origin, so only pi encirclement here. If here I have a plane in which I have two poles and one zero, and I encircle these pole and zero, and I consider a clockwise direction. So when number of poles is greater than number of zeros, then direction always change when I map this in GSHS plane. Like I map this, and here the direction is anti-clockwise, and it comes from this formula. N is the my encirclement, P is my number of poles, Z is my number of zeros. When I put number of poles is equal to 2, Z is equal to 1, I got some positive number, and I always consider positive direction is my counterclockwise. So I got this type of, let I have two zeros in my system, and I encircle this, and I got this type of direction. I let this type of direction, and I map it in GH plane. This is my GH plane. So like this type of circle I got, and over here I have to find the direction, which is n is equal to number of pole, which is 1, minus number of zeros, 2, it is negative. So negative sign for clockwise direction. So my direction does not change in this case, and my direction change in this case. Okay. So in Nyquist plot, I have a open loop system, which is my transfer function, and I have a characteristic equation 1 plus gh, that is my closed loop transfer function. I can map these two using Nyquist plot. For the stability, I always use my characteristic equation, which is my gshs 1 plus gshs, and I can write it as gshs is equal to minus 1 plus goj, and its magnitude is 1 and phase is minus 180, plus minus 180. Okay, so now I consider encirclement of minus 1 plus 0j for open loop system, open loop transfer function, and encirclement of 0 plus 0j for closed loop transfer function. Because here my GSHS is my open loop transfer function, over here my 1 plus GSHS is my closed loop transfer function. So it can encircle 0 and it encircle minus 1. Okay. So I modify my N is equal to P minus Z formula, which is the base formula of Nyquist plot. N is the encirclement of minus 1 plus 0j in case of open loop transfer function, and P plus is my open loop transfer function poles in right half of S plane, and Z plus is my poles of closed loop transfer function in right half of S plane. Okay, so note this. For the stability, I require 0 closed loop poles in my right half, means I did not place any poles in right half of S plane. So when I put Z plus is equal to 0, my N is equal to peak. So my encirclement of minus 1 should be always equal to number of poles in right half of open loop poles in right half of S plane for a stable system. Like one example, here is the example. I consider GSHS is equal to 1 upon S into S plus 1. Okay. For this type of system, first I draw a polar plot, which is like this. This is the polar plot of 1 upon S plus 1. I draw a mirror image of this, This is the mirror image. And I encircle, now I encircle this, and encirclement of this is comes from pole at origin. Pole at origin, one pole at origin gives pi encirclement, two pole at origin gives 2 pi encirclement, and so on. And encirclement direction is always clockwise, and it starts from when my mirror image ends over here. I start my encirclement in this direction because my polar plot gives me this direction, from here to here, then here, it goes from here, then here, and it starts from here in clockwise direction, and from here it ends over the starting point of my polar plot. Okay, this is the Nyquist plot of my system 1 upon S plus 1. Now there are some points regarding this encirclement start from end of Nyquist plot in clockwise direction, and ends, encirclement ends at start of Nyquist plot in clockwise direction. Okay, now I consider another example. In this example, I have a transfer function GSHS is my 10 upon S cube S plus 10. Over here, I have three poles in my open loop transfer function. So number of encirclement is equal to 3 into pi, which is 3 pi. So my polar plot for this type of system is like this. And direction is this. I mirror image over here. This is my polar plot of this system. I mirror image of this. Again, I start encirclement from here. It is the end point of mirror image. I goes from here, 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 here in clockwise direction. It is pi. Again, 2 pi. And again, it is 3 pi. And I attach this point to starting point of my polar plot. Okay, this is the Nyquist plot of my system. Now here comes the stability criteria. My stability criteria told me when n is equal to p plus minus z plus, n is the encirclement of minus 1, p plus number of poles in right half, and z plus number of poles of closed loop system in right half. Here is the number of poles in right half of open loop system. So my encirclement is 1, 2. Here 1, and this is 2. Number of encirclement 2. It is minus because it is in clockwise direction. So number of poles in right half from here 0. So my z plus is equal to 2. It gives me 2 right half closed loop poles, means my system is unstable. I can check this using Routh criteria also. Now I can check the stability of this system, which is my GSHS is equal to 1 upon S cube into S plus 10, this system, using Routh criteria. My characteristic equation is GSHS is equal to 0, and from here I got S4 plus 10 S cube plus 0 S square plus 0 S1 plus 10 is equal to 0. This is my characteristic equation, and using Routh criteria, this is my S4, my terms are 1, 0, 10, S3 is my 10, 0, 0, S square is this into this minus this into this, it gives me 0, and this into this minus this into this gives me 1. Okay, and again, when I got a 0 over here, I replace it 0 by epsilon, which is very less or near to 0. So I put epsilon over here, and my S1 becomes this into this minus this into this minus 10 over epsilon. I got this, and from here I got 0, and my S0 is, so from here, this into this minus this into this upon this, I got value is equal to minus 10 upon epsilon into 1 minus epsilon into 0 upon minus 10 upon epsilon, which is equal to 1. So number of sign change, positive to positive, positive to positive, positive to negative, negative to positive. So number of sign change are positive to negative and negative to positive. The two sign chains are there. So number of poles in right half of S plane are 2. So this is my unstable system. Thank you.